Ben Graham once said, "The individual investor should act consistently as an investor and not as a speculator." While technical analysis and other forms of analysis that attempt to time entry and exit points in a stock are valuable tools for short-term investments, fundamentals are the backbone of making long-term investing decisions.
We're still playing for ultimately the market is down 30 to 50% from its peak because multiples still have to go down.
What does Dan Niles mean when he speaks of multiples having to come down? At its core, valuation multiples are a convenient way to assess the relative value of a stock versus competing stocks and investments. Here we see Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway A share's current price of around $400,000 per share. If we compare this to Apple at roughly $140, the price for Berkshire looks much more expensive in comparison. But is it? Each industry, from semiconductors like AMD, to hotels, to car makers, and crypto platforms like Coinbase, is gauged by the investor community on a valuation multiple. The most commonly discussed multiple is the price-to-earnings multiple, which simply put, is calculated by taking the current share price and dividing it by the company's forward expected earnings per share. Think of earnings per share as the leftover cash after a company earns revenue from sales, paying off its suppliers, employees, rent, operating expenses, and taxes, then this total amount left over divided by all the total shares available. Let's take another look at Warren Buffett's $400,000 per share stock again. This time, it's price-to-earnings multiple. Here we can see that at current levels, the implied forward price-to-earning multiple is 19.1 times. And if we take another look at Apple at $140, Apple's price-to-earning multiple is currently 21.5 times, implying that even though Berkshire's share point is much, much higher, Apple is actually the more expensive stock. Evaluating price-to-earning multiples is just one step of many to evaluate the fundamentals of a stock. If you haven't noticed, the price component of the PE multiple fluctuates every day. Meaning, assuming the earnings per share estimates do not change, these multiples can vary wildly. Let's assume Apple's forward earnings per share of $6.50 per share shown here holds. Then, at Apple's 1-year share price high of $182.94, the implied PE multiple was 28 times. At its 1-year low of roughly $129 per share, this represents 19.8 times. What is the right multiple for Apple? Warren Buffett, one of the greatest investors of all time, has publicly said that it's far better to buy a wonderful company at a fair price than a fair company at a wonderful price. What is a fair price? Or, said more appropriately now that we can view companies from the perspective of price-to-earning multiples, the quest to find the appropriate fair price for a stock is an endless endeavor and can involve the implementation of fairly sophisticated analysis to triangulate what is appropriate. We'll cover these approaches in future videos, but for today, let's start with some basics. For starters, it is always worthwhile to see where the current valuation of a stock ranks versus what a stock has historically traded at. Earlier, we discussed Apple trading at a forward price-to-earning multiple of 28 times to as low as 19 times. So how to quickly ascertain where today's price-to-earning multiple of 28 times ranks versus historically? Here we are looking at the enterprise value to revenue or sales multiple, but the logic is similar. You can see how Apple's current multiple of 5.6 times relative to its multiple over the last 36 months ranks it in the 58th percentile. And if we look at where the 5.6 times ranks in the last 12 and 6 months, it's in the single digit range. Said differently, in the last 12 months, 98% of the time, Apple's multiple was above the current multiple for Apple of 5.6 times. Additionally, this also means the 5.6 times valuation for Apple has only occurred 2% of the time over the last 12 months. While this doesn't fully indicate that you should rush to buy Apple, as a long-term investor, one of the first steps to determining if a stock is at a fair price is buying it at a discount relative to its valuation historically. You might be wondering, who determines what Apple is supposed to make next year in sales? In earnings per share? I see that Apple is expected to make $410 billion in sales, but how? Remember, these estimates are not set in stone. They move around based on expectations and the economic environment. Wall Street pays the analysts that track these companies and come up with estimates millions of dollars per year to do this for you. And we at Wewave update the average or the consensus estimates in real time so you can work with the latest updates. In addition to earnings estimates, the analysts issue price targets and buy, sell, hold ratings regularly. A secret tip from Wall Street veterans is to largely ignore price targets and the associated ratings. It is always best to formulate your own opinions on this, though the earnings estimates are usually pretty useful given the estimates are usually the result of advanced financial modeling with the aid of company executives. What if you want to jump into the deep end and calculate your own estimates? The best starting place, if you're brave enough to take on this endeavor, is to look at Apple's official financial filings with the SEC here. We'll go over the other filings in a future video, but today the two filings to focus on are the 10Q and 10K filings. The 10Q filing is filed quarterly by Apple and any publicly traded company in the United States, and the 10K filing is filed annually and includes the prior year's total results. For starters, you would model out the income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow statement to come up with your own estimates. To see a completed version of a company's model, we have in our library a real-life model made by Wall Street analysts at Goldman Sachs for Apple. Pay attention to see how the analyst models out the company's drivers by segments such as iPhone sales, iPad sales, and others, and also breaks down the potential future revenues down by geography from America to China to Europe and worldwide. Going back to consensus Wall Street estimates, we can see here how closely Wall Street has tracked the actual results in the past several quarters and what they expect in the coming quarters. It is fascinating that Apple is expected to grow revenues by 10% the next quarter versus last year, and by 7% in the quarter after missing expectations this recent quarter by -2% and only beating by +2% prior. Do you think Apple is primed to beat here? As of the making of this video, Apple has bounced +16% in the last 30 days, so the market is definitely getting a bit more optimistic. So at this point, you've done your homework on some fundamentals and you have some price targets set. This is where technical analysis can aid you in timing. We'll go over the basics of technicals today, but some basics are that you should look at the price action in the stock you're analyzing itself, the stock relative to wider indexes like the S&P 500 or the NASDAQ 100, and generally, the analysis you're performing at its most basic level is identifying common patterns that have occurred time and time again in the markets. Wewave utilizes cutting-edge AI to quickly identify these patterns, as you can see here, for stocks and cryptocurrencies and other asset classes that may be of interest to you. One of the most followed patterns in technicals is the golden cross, which can be defined as any shorter-term moving average crossing beyond a longer-term moving average. Our basic definition for now is the 50-day or 50-time-frame moving average moving above the 200-time-frame moving average. Wewave allows you to quickly identify these breakouts in real time during market hours for a broad variety of asset classes. Let's take another look at Apple and technical patterns that may have formed since its last earnings. Our latest suite of tools on Wewave.app allows users to seamlessly adjust the pattern match zone to identify stocks, ETFs, cryptocurrencies, and other securities that trade similar to Apple, as well as the inverse, which we'll cover in a future video. But for now, let's look at what patterns may be forming for Apple since its latest earnings event on July 28, 2022. Interestingly, after running up in a straight line by nearly $20 per share or +12% since earnings, we are starting to see a pullback on Apple, and our pattern match algo is flagging a potential bearish inverted cup and handle pattern, though it has not fully formed yet given the match percentage is just roughly 76%. Is this a good time to buy the dip in Apple, or is it wise to wait out the full formation of the bearish pattern before dipping in? There are many questions still left to answer, but that's what makes a market. If you think the bearish pattern will continue to form, it is best to wait to buy Apple, or perhaps short Apple to extract profits on a potential downside move. Everyone will have their own opinion and views, but equipped with our cutting-edge tools, a user can enter these types of trades with more confidence. Let's also remember that the estimated forward earnings per share is $6.50, so at approximately $1.60 per share, you are paying 25 times, or a price-to-earnings multiple of 25. As of the making of this video, the S&P 500 or the SPY ETF trades at approximately 17 times forward price to earning. Apple will always be at a premium to the SPY, so that is something to consider as well. The union of technicals and fundamentals are the cornerstones of developing a strong investing framework, which we'll go over in more detail in the future, so stay tuned. Today we have gone over the basics of fundamental and technical analysis, which is the jump-off point for broadening your toolkit for assessing investment opportunities in financial markets. In future segments, we'll expand more on the approaches we outlined here, as we are barely touching the tip of the iceberg now. If you are interested in learning more, please consider supporting us by exploring www.wewave.app, and if you made it this far, drop us a comment, like, and subscribe for a free trial access to Wewave Pro. Thanks for watching. See you next time.